As we continue talking more about infectious diseases, a requested molecule for us to break down is known as rifampicin, also abbreviated as RIF. So let's discuss that today. This is an antibiotic primarily used for the treatment of tuberculosis, but it can be used for other bacterial infections as well. And if one is interested in taking this drug, it's important to discuss this with your healthcare provider, as it has a strict adherence schedule where it needs to be taken every day for up to 4 months to treat tuberculosis. And the way that it works is it takes advantage of the central dogma of biology, which states that our DNA turns into mRNA, and then that is turned into proteins. And in between the process of DNA going to RNA or mRNA, it uses a protein known as RNA polymerase to exert that effect. But when rifampicin is taken, it's actually able to go in and block RNA polymerase. Therefore, that DNA from the bacteria can't be converted into the bacterial mRNA. So therefore, downstream, the bacteria is not able to make the proteins that it needs in order to survive and grow. But one question you may be having is, how is rifampicin able to target bacterial RNA polymerase when us as humans also use this exact same process, so we have our own RNA polymerase? Well, that's because bacteria have one type of RNA polymerase, but humans actually have three. And that's because we're able to turn different parts of our DNA into different mRNA, and the sizes of those RNA polymerase are different, therefore allowing rifampicin to be highly specific to that bacterial RNA polymerase. So to learn more about the infectious disease space, make sure to stay connected to my channel and with Dane Garvin.